Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. So if you are here, you have probably seen my Corsair Lighting Node Pro unboxing, setup and review video. If not, you can go ahead and watch that first if you want to. You just need to click right here and then come back after watching. Come on.
Do it.
Oh, you don't want to? Okay, let's continue then. Today we are going to test out a presumption, or let's say a theory of mine that the LED chips that are in Corsair's Lighting Node Pro LED strips are the same type of LED chips that are used on relatively cheap WS2812B addressable RGB LED strips. And then, if my theory turns out to be correct, I will show you how you can add more RGB LED strips on your desk or inside your case for a cheaper price, and still be able to use IQ to control them, even without buying the expansion kit. Let's go! Alright, first things first. This is assuming that you already have a Corsair Lighting Node Pro. I haven't tried it on other controllers yet, so I'm not sure if it would work on others, but if the LED strips that your controller uses have the same chips and power rating, it's plausible that your controller uses WS2812B as well. Just a disclaimer, you should make sure that your controller is compatible with the LED strip that you would use. I'm not going to be responsible for any damages it can do to your system. Do this at your own risk. Now that that's out of the way, here are the things that we are going to need in order for us to proceed with the tests and implementation. An Arduino Uno board. This is for us to find out if we could control the Lighting Node Pro's LED strip using the WS2812B or NeoPixel library. A WS2812B or NeoPixel RGB LED strip, of course. A soldering iron and soldering lead for connecting the wires for power and data. A glue gun or hot glue gun for securing the connections. An RGB LED wire for cleaner and easier wire management. A few male-to-male and male-to-female jumper cables. And of course, a wire stripper. Not necessary, but it's just faster to unsleeve wires when using one. There are also a few things that I have failed to mention here, which we are going to see later. Now, let's open this one up. Here it is. These wires right here are for the power and data. Red for 5 volts, white for ground, and green for data. It's also conveniently indicated right here. 5 volts red, ground white, DIN or data in or data input is the green one. And this is the Lighting Node Pro's LED strip, which has 10 LEDs per strip. If we count the WS2812B's number of LEDs per strip at the same length, we would have 17 LEDs. Now, the LN Pro's max number of RGB LED strip per controller is 12. And since each controller has 2 channels, that would make it 6 strips per channel, or 60 RGB LEDs. Using only 17 LEDs would be illogical, so I opted to use 20 to make the LED count equal to 60. Because I'm planning to attach one strip on each of my two monitors, and that would make it 40 LEDs. And when we add the other two strips with 10 LEDs each inside the case, that would make it exactly 60 LEDs. Okay, we're gonna cut it right about here. It's a good thing that this particular roll can be cut into individual LEDs too. Others can only be cut every 5 or 10 LEDs. Now that we have cut it into our desired length, let's do some tests. Using the jumper wires, let's connect some leads. Again, red for 5 volts, green for data in or input, and white for the ground. After that, connect the leads to the Arduino. Ground to ground, 5 volts to 5 volts, and the data would be on digital pin number 2. Okay, let's hook up the Arduino. There it is. Launch Visual Studio Code. Go to Platform IO IDE, click on Devices to check if the Arduino is detected. There it is on COM3. Then, click on Home, Import Arduino Projects, locate the NeoPixel Library Examples, Animation, select Board, and then click on Import. There it is. Click on SRC and then NeoPixel Animation. Change the pixel count to 20, and since we have already connected the LED strip's data pin to digital pin number 2, we're not going to change anything on this part. After that, click on Build. After a successful build, click on Upload. And there it is. Let's try another sample. Let's say Cylon. And there you have it. Let's unplug the Arduino to turn it off and then connect the LN Pro strip to it. Now, you might ask why I'm not using a digital multimeter or something to test and find out what the voltage requirements is. And I'm telling you, besides the fact that I'm just lazy and forgot about it, there is no need for that. The voltage requirement for the Lightning Node Pro is on the manual, and the requirements for the WS2812B is on its schematics. As you can see here, the input requirement for the Lightning Node Pro is 4.5 to 5.5 volts. Not sure why the number of RGB LED strip per channel is just 4 though, I mean it's different from what is stated on their website's product page. And, according to its schematics, it's plus 3.5 to plus 5.3 volts on the WS2812B strip, so I'm quite confident. Okay, let's get back on track. Change the pixel count to 10 first, click on build, and then upload the code. And there it is. Interesting. So, judging by the results of the tests that we have done, we can now conclude that the LEDs on the Lightning Node Pro are just common WS2812B chips. And we can probably just connect the WS2812B strip to Lightning Node Pro without doing any modifications or having some problems. I mean, if you take a closer look at both of the LED chips from the LN Pro and WS2812B or NeoPixel, although the capacitor of the LN Pro is on the other side, they're exactly the same. And since I've used quite a lot of NeoPixels on my previous projects, you can click right here to check those out by the way, I know what it looks like. But, just to be sure that the NeoPixel would work on the LN Pro controller, let's do some tests anyway. So, I'm going to connect this LN Pro strip to the other one that is already on my case. And just to see that we are on the correct channel, I'm going to turn it on and off. Alright, now click on Channel Setup. Channel 2, change the strip count to 3. Then get some male to female jumper cables. If we take a look at the connector that's on the LN Pro strip, it's quite different from the usual ARGB connector because it's proprietary I think. But, by using a jumper cable, we can still connect to it even without an official Corsair connector. The connections are like this. This time, ground is the black jumper cable. Alright, connect it to the NeoPixel strip and if all things go as planned, this NeoPixel strip would get power and data from the LN Pro strip and light up. Let's add another effect. There it is. And because LN Pro strips only have 10 LEDs each, only half of the NeoPixel strip lit up. So we have to add another strip on the lighting setup. Make it 4 strips, and there you go. Perfect! Now that we have proof that the NeoPixel strip would work with the LN Pro and be controlled by it without any hiccups, time to do some soldering. After soldering, let's check if the LN Pro can handle an additional 20 NeoPixel LEDs. Okay, go to the lighting setup again, and this time make it 6 strips. And there you have it! Now to secure the connections of the solder jumper cables to the NeoPixel strip, I'm going to use my glue gun. I needed to secure them because I tend to remove my monitors on my desk every week when I clean, so they would be disconnected and reconnected quite a lot. This right here will be an RGB extension cable which would carry the data and power signals from the LN Pro strips inside the case to the NeoPixel strips that would be attached to the back of the monitors later. To attach the NeoPixel strips at the back of my monitor, I used both a double-sided tape and Velcro, so that I can remove and replace it if it somehow breaks or for some reason if I don't want it anymore. And as you can see here, I have made a mistake. I forgot to separate them, because as I have said earlier, I tend to remove my monitors on my desk when I do my weekly cleaning, and unless I remove and carry them at the same time without potentially damaging the connections, I would need a way to disconnect them. So now I will cut it in the middle and solder some male and female headers to them. And it's done! I have also added some shrink tube for added protection. So I just attached the NeoPixel strips at the back of my two monitors, here's one of them. This right here will be connected to my main monitor, and this one will be connected to the extension that I have made earlier and will be routed to these things for wire management. And this is the strip that is attached on my main monitor. Again, I made a mistake here, but I just flipped the strip so that the input would be on the left side. This is the RGB extension that we have made earlier. I utilized the jumper cables here again. This time, I used a female-to-male jumper cable. The female side is attached to the LN Pro strip on channel 2 and the male side is attached to the RGB extension. I did not connect the extension to the LN Pro strip directly because I just cut that from a female header group, not sure what it's called, but this is what it looks like. And then, the RGB extension cable is connected to the first NeoPixel strip that is attached at the back of the second monitor. Looks like the other wire management thing fell off though. Now let's do some more tests just to see if it would really work without a hitch. Just cycle some color profiles and find out if the attached NeoPixel strips would act weird. As you can see on the static white profile which was supposed to show white LEDs, the second NeoPixel strip that is on the main monitor is discolored. Okay, let's take a closer look. Let's check if the problem is repeatable. So right now, the 3D color profile is currently active and working just fine on the NeoPixel strips. However, if we switch to static white profile, the second NeoPixel strip is not showing white LEDs at all. Oh, I'm using my phone here by the way. And if we compare its color to the first set of NeoPixel strip that is attached on the second monitor, it becomes clearer that the color degradation only occurs on the second NeoPixel strip. See that? This is white and the other one is like orange, almost. Now for the important question. Why is it doing that? Well, discoloration or color degradation occurs when there is lack of current. Maybe that's why Corsair decided to put 4 LED strips max on the LN Pro manual instead of what is stated on the website description, which is 12 RGB LED strips max or 6 for each channel. Do take note though that it's running just fine even with 6 LED strips or 60 LEDs on one channel. Just don't use the static effect with the color white. The white rain color profile works okay even without attaching the supplementary power because the white LED's animation is just blinking randomly and would not require all LEDs to turn on. Now, what can we do to solve this lack of current or power issue? Well, luckily, I have a 5V 3A DC power adapter or power supply that I usually use on my DIY electronics projects. We can use this to supplement or supply additional power to the NeoPixel LED strips. And to do that, we're going to use a female DC barrel jack. One end to be connected to the power adapter and the other end to the 5V and ground leads of the NeoPixel LED strip. Here's how everything is connected. So this is the case and the LN Pro LED strip inside it. This is the second monitor where the first NeoPixel strip is attached. The main monitor where the second NeoPixel strip is attached. And this is the 5V 3A DC power supply adapter. This is the input side of the first NeoPixel or WS2812B RGB LED strip. This is the equivalent input side of the second strip that is attached on the main monitor. And this one is the output side of the first NeoPixel strip. The power and data lines of the first NeoPixel strip is connected to the LN Pro via the RGB extension cable that we have made earlier. And LED strip 1's data out, 5V and ground are connected to the input side of the second LED strip. Now this is the female DC barrel jack. One end is connected to the power supply adapter and the other side is connected to the first NeoPixel strip's 5V and ground. Alright, I'm going to turn off the LEDs first. As you can see here, I have already stripped the sleeves of the supplementary power leads of the LED strip using my wire stripper. All we need to do now is connect the LED strip's supplementary power leads to the barrel jack. Now that it's connected, let's turn off the lights and turn on the LEDs again. As you can clearly see on this part, the LEDs are not white, right? Let's attach the 5V 3A DC power supply or adapter and plug it in. Right away, even if the camera is not pointed to the NeoPixel strips, we can see the color change. See, if I remove the power supply, the color degradation would be back. And if we plug it back in, it disappears. Now you might ask, how did I know what power supply to use? For that, we need to do some maths. Okay?
Okay!
Basically, each WS2812B LED chip has 3 LEDs that require 20 milliamps of current each. So that is 20 milliamps for red, 20 milliamps for green, and 20 milliamps for blue, or RGB. And in order for it to produce the white color or hue, all of the LEDs must be turned on. Here's an example. Think of the 255 color value here as the LED being turned on or receiving 20 milliamps of current, and of course, 0 as off or no current. So if the blue LED is turned on or receives 20 milliamps of current and the other two are off, blue LEDs would be shown. Same would happen for the green and red. But if we turn on red and green simultaneously, it would produce yellow color or hue. And if we turn them all on, it would produce white. And if all LEDs, the red, green, and blue that is, are turned on, it would require 60 milliamps of current. Now, we have 20 NeoPixel LEDs on each strip and we have two of them. That would mean an additional strain of 20 LEDs on the LN Pro. Again, the max number of LEDs per channel on the LN Pro manual is just 4. And on this setup, we have 6. If we want to show the color white, those 40 LEDs would require 2400 milliamps or 2.4 amps of current. Because 40 LEDs multiplied by 60 milliamps or the required current to turn the RGB LEDs all on is equal to 2400 milliamps. That's why I used a 5 volts 3 amps DC adapter or power supply. I mean, besides the fact that this is the only adapter that I conveniently have. Discoloration or color degradation occurs only when showing white though, because all the LEDs needed to be turned on when showing it and therefore requires more current. In conclusion, this method of adding more RGB lights might seem quite daunting or difficult at first, but it's actually easy once you know the correct power requirements and know what to look for. This method is intended to save money. I mean, instead of buying an LED expansion kit which is like $40 each, you can just buy a 5-meter roll of WS2812B RGB LED strip. It's way longer too. Plus, a few more things that are also cheap and you can make one for yourself. You can also expand or add more NeoPixel strips if you want as long as you can provide it with enough juice and as long as your controller can handle it. Now, I'm not saying that doing this is better than just buying an expansion kit. No. I'm just letting you guys know that it is possible to make one on your own. That's it. Thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.